Hi everybody, welcome back to Karen Puzzles. Today is just a really quick, fun, informal video where I'm gonna show you guys all of the new puzzles that I've gotten lately. The first thing that we have is this giant, very heavy box. Look at how big that box is. Can you imagine how many puzzles are in there? You don't have to imagine. I'm gonna show you in like 2 seconds. This is from Eboo. They're coming out with a bunch of new puzzles, a ton of new products. They're all so gorgeous, so they offered to send me some, and if you saw the title of this video, yes, there's going to be a giveaway. Yes, the giveaway will be of Eboo puzzles, but before I get to that, let me show you everything they sent me. Oh, and also, you might have seen the photo on my Instagram. I actually got to go meet the Eboo team in person when I was in New York last week. They actually sent me this before I met them, or before that was even arranged. And then when I posted that I was in New York, they were like, hey, we're in New York, come say hi. So I was like, okay. And so I got to meet the Eboo team, which was so great. They're so nice. I got to see their office, which was amazing. So many puzzles. I got a little sneak peek of some of their new products that aren't out yet. I can't talk about those, but I can talk about what they sent me. So I'm gonna stop rambling and get into this box. First, I'm gonna put it on the floor because I cannot move with it on my lap. Okay, so we have 6 puzzles in here. I'm gonna do a little phone video so that I can show you guys. So this is what came in the box. We have 2 copies of the catalog, which I'll get to in a minute. We have this little tote bag, which again, I'll get to in a minute. Some really fun colored tissue paper, and then there it is, the puzzles. Is that not the most beautiful box you could ever imagine getting in the mail? So here we have Frida Kahlo. This is their Viva La Vida puzzle. It is a square puzzle, 23 by 23 inches, 1,000 pieces. And something that I learned when I was at their office is that they just redesigned the sides of their boxes. So here's one with the old design, and then here's one with the new design. So you can see how that looks a little different. The boxes are also a slightly different size now. It looks like they're about an inch smaller on all sides. I don't know how well you can see that on camera, but the box size is a little bit smaller. You get a little bit more of the picture of the puzzle on the side, and it looks like they've gotten rid of this kind of circusy font. Now it's just more of a sans serif font that's a little easier to read on store shelves, which is how they explained it to me. And then I might as well talk about this one since it's already in my hand. This one is called Flower Calendar. And again, look at how beautiful that is. It reminds me of the, there's the whole picture on the back. It reminds me of the astrology puzzle that I did from Ravensburger with this center little thing with the different months broken out of it, and then different pictures coming out for each month. Very similar design, but this is much more colorful, so I think it'll be a little more fun to do than the 9,000 piece puzzle that was like half stars. Here we have one that is called Firecracker Labels. How cool is that? Look at how detailed all of those pictures are. That's gonna be so fun to do as a puzzle. I cannot wait. Look at how beautiful. It's so saturated. Look at that. I love those colors. And it looks, so a puzzle like this, it looks difficult because there's a lot of little details, but easy because you have a lot of straight lines that you can match up when you match up the different textures, which is the difficulty level that I love. Like, there's something happening everywhere, so you don't have huge sections with nothing going on, but it's also not super easy because there is a lot going on everywhere. I might make a whole video about that, about what makes a puzzle easy or hard. Let me know if that's something that you would be interested in. Next, we have another 1,000 piece puzzle. This one is called UFO Victorian Ladies, which, yes, please, that's everything I want in life. This one is another one with their new box design. So here is what the picture looks like on the back. How fun is that? Oh, I love this. I cannot wait to do it. Again, the colors are so beautiful. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you know that I have always loved colorful puzzles and I've always preferred illustrations more than photography. So basically, Ebu was a company that was made for me because every single one of their puzzles are my favorite type of puzzle to do. Okay, next we have this one, which is called Paris in a Day. And this one is not square, it is a rectangle. I asked them about that when I was in the office, and basically if the box is square, then the puzzle is going to be square, and if the box is a rectangle, then the puzzle will be a rectangle. Simple enough. Something that I'm noticing on this one, though, is that this graphic on the front is covering up part of the picture, and then on the back of these rectangle puzzles, they don't show the entire picture. So I wonder if they have a little printout inside to show you the entire thing, because that's kind of a pet peeve of mine with puzzles, is when the graphics on the box cover up part of the picture, so you never get a whole picture of, you know, what the puzzle is. So I'm actually just gonna open this one up right now and we're gonna find out. Try to use a mechanical pencil to open this tape, even though I have about 800 pairs of scissors in this apartment. None of them are within arm's reach. Okay, so I'm opening it up and we have the pieces in a bag. Okay, that's what I thought. They do have a little printout inside that shows you the entire puzzle design. So there we go, a crisis averted. What a terrible tragedy that would have been. And then finally, the very last puzzle that they sent me is called Goddesses, Warriors, Deities, and Heroines from Around the World. So it basically looks like a Marvel superhero illustration, except it is women of all different cultures. That is so cool. This is a 500 piece round puzzle. I love that. And then, oh, look at that. They have a little educational poster that they've included. That is so cool. I love when puzzles can also be educational. So here we go. There's a little cheat sheet of where everyone's from. So they have someone from Greece, Japan, a Celtic woman, Germanic, West African, Egyptian, Chinese, Mayan, and Persian. Super cool. Look at how beautiful that is. Another thing that I love about Ebu, and just FYI, they're not paying me to say any of this. They did send me all these puzzles for free, but I just genuinely love them as a company. They are a like female-run company. Most of their employees are female. They have very feminist designs. Obviously this one, they have the Women's March puzzle. Jigsaw puzzles are not necessarily like a gendered hobby, but just to have products like these specifically for women, as a woman, I appreciate and I love. So a huge thank you to Ebu for all of those. Now I'm gonna talk about the giveaway. So I always do my giveaways over on Instagram just because it's easier to like get comments over there and reply back and forth to people. So I recently reached 3,000 followers on Instagram, which I'm so excited about. So I had the idea to give away 3 1,000 piece puzzles to one lucky winner, and Ebu is kind enough to provide those puzzles to the winner. Okay, so I just picked my three favorites from what they have just sent me, and this is gonna be the prize. You're gonna get Paris in a Day, you are going to get Flower Calendar, and you're also going to get Viva La Vida. So all of these will be linked down below if you just want to buy them for yourself, or if you want to try to enter the giveaway, all of the details for that will be right down below. And if for some reason, because I have not run this past them, that these are the specific ones for the prizes, if we have to switch it out, I will also put that down below, but you know, we're just gonna go for it right now. Okay, and then just to finish off this little Ebu love fest, they also sent me this tote bag, super cute. If you didn't know, they also do like children's educational materials, all beautifully illustrated and designed, so that is very cute. And then they also sent me two copies of their holiday catalog, which I already saw as a PDF that they emailed to me, but I love seeing this as like a full-on printed booklet. How beautiful. It's so well designed. They have all of their new puzzles in there. Just like their photography, like you guys know if you follow my Instagram that I love puzzle photography. Look at how pretty that is. I love that so much. Okay, let's move on. So I've gotten two more puzzles in the mail recently, and these are from Better Co. So this is a brand new puzzle brand by a guy who just decided to start a puzzle brand, and he has three puzzles, but he sent me two of them. So if I like them, I'll definitely have to get my hands on the third. But we have Modern Art Puzzle, which is so modern and beautiful. I love the colors. And then you guys know I cannot resist a good gradient puzzle. I cannot wait to try this one. I am planning to do a full review of this brand. So if you, are curious about the quality of it, I cannot tell you yet, but if you subscribe and stay tuned, I will be able to tell you very soon. And then I have one more thing to show you. So this was not sent to me by the company. I literally just saw it in a store and had to have it. It is this teeny, teeny, tiny little Kekerland puzzle. How cute is that? It basically comes in like a matchbox. It was $5. I got it at the Kekerland store in Chelsea Market when I was in New York, and I just thought it was so cute. I really want to try it out on camera and see what the quality is actually like. So once again, stay tuned for that. And then, yeah, the only other new puzzle that that I've gotten recently is the Crypt Ravensburger puzzle, which I actually did buy with my own money. I do have a contact at Ravensburger, but trying to get products from them, not from them, but from like any company specifically, you have to like put in the request, wait for them to process it, wait for them to send it to you. So I was just like, I'm not gonna bother. I just bought this on Amazon Prime and had it 2 days later. But I already made the video about this, so if you haven't seen that, definitely go watch it. This was a lot. I kind of had a little bit of a nervous breakdown and I captured it all on camera. So I'll link that video down below if you haven't seen it yet. And those are all of my new puzzles. I'm so excited to do the Ebu puzzles and to pick the winner of the giveaway. All of the information for that will be in the description. So make sure you read that and follow me on Instagram so that you know about any other giveaways that are going to be happening. And I think that's it for me. I have been rambling about puzzles for 17 minutes, so that's going to be fun to edit. I've got to go. a code word for the comments. I don't even know. Let me look. The code word for the comments will be Paris. There you go. So if you put that in your comment, I'll know that you watched the entire video. And now I'm gonna go. So happy puzzling, and I'll see you all next time.